What up, everybody? We are back again with another project. This is Professor Student. Why Professor Student? Because I'm here to teach you whatever I've learned, and whatever I learn, I teach. We are back doing another one of my favorite pieces of wood, I guess you want to say, or slabs of wood. Pistachio. I love working with this stuff because it has so much character in it, and you can make it do all kinds of crazy stuff. Basically because it has so many different colors, so much different style, so much character in it, just by leaving it raw. I mean, you can add a darker stain, a lighter stain. Of course, you guys should know by now, I like to just stay with a natural stain to let the wood do all the talking. So we're going to be making a bench today. Pistachio bench. Again, like I said, the wood's going to be pistachio. Going to be doing something different. A lot of people always wonder what you can do with your recycled resin. People think you just got to throw it away, trash it, so try to use as little as you can. I'm going to show you that that's not true. You can reuse your resin right here. Reuse it, recycle it, however you want to put it. I'm going to show you how to do this in this project. Length of it, the size of it. Saying plus or minus because I'll show you in a minute what I'm trying to do. I want to get it around 50 inches 14 length, and then 14 inches wide. We should be able to hold the 14 inches wide length. As far as the main base, I should say, of probably the resin, probably going to be like a little black tinted smoke or something. One of the key things in this will be to close all the edges, which I'll explain in a minute. And minimal resin use. Why am I saying that? Because two things I want to try to show you how to do in this project here. One is recycled resin. The other one is what happens if I don't have enough resin to finish the project. I know that happens to a lot of you guys, whether you want to admit it or not. And before you know it, you either got to stop your project, not do it, run down to the, well, wherever, either order it or run down to your hardware store or whatever and buy some more resin. But I'm going to show you by using your recycled resin, using minimal resin, and if your numbers are right, which hopefully mine are, you might be able to still do your project. And of course, I put in here, don't cheat. That's mainly for me, is not trying to sneak in, add more resin on you guys and make you think that I'm doing something that I can't do, which a lot of people online do. If you haven't figured that out on YouTube, I love all my wood guys to death, but they cheat, and they know they cheat. But hugs and kisses all around, whatever. So once again, we're down here. 14 by 36 is going to be where I'm starting. So this is going to be the size of the wood slab and the bench that I'm going to be cutting to make first, okay? And then what's going to happen is we're going to split it in two. Why? Because we want to be able to make a 50-inch bench, but we only have enough resin, material, whatever, to make 36. So this, again, is where we're trying to do more with less. So we're going to basically do our 14 by 36. We're going to cast it in that. We're going to do our resin and everything in this in the 36 length range. Then we're gonna cut this in half, so we end up with two 18 by 18 pieces. We're gonna have like a little gap in the center, which should bring us to about our 40 to 50. The reason why I say 40 to 50 is depending on this gap here, you know, plus or minus an inch or two, or maybe an inch or whatever, see how it looks. I don't wanna put too big of a gap there and then it doesn't look right. I don't wanna do too small of a gap for the exact same reason where it doesn't look right. It's like, why'd you have a gap there? So that's the idea. Pretty much straightforward bench. I didn't really draw too much of the frame idea because I'm pretty much just going to keep it simple as a box frame. Might put something on the shoe rack on the bottom, but I don't think it's too big of a deal for this. I mean, for me to technically be pointing out in this section. Maybe towards the middle of the end, I'll kind of show you what I did with the frame. And highlight that. But anyways, here we are. We'll get started. Once again, Professor Student, pistachio bench, recycled resin. Don't cheat. That's for me. Let's knock this thing out. See what we can do. All right. Okay, so here's just a sample of, or an example. Well, it's not an example. These are the blanks that I'm going to be using. I do apologize. So you're not going to be able to really see the true color. of these things. I've tried different angles, it doesn't really work good, but you get an idea. It's just the blanks or whatever you're left with at the bottom of your barrels or your pots or whatever it is, your mixing cups or anything. This is a kind of a dark color here. It's kind of got a greenish tint to it. You maybe seen it there. See it there. This is more like a cream white color that I'm going to use. It's actually three-tone, really. If you can see there, there's a little bit of green in there. And then this side is more like a brown, reddish brown or brown. So should get some stuff out of here. Let's get at the bottom of your dill. And then these are like some little pucks. Resin brown here. Emerald green, looks like. And a translucent bluish. So, like I said, we'll be using this on this project here. How am I going to use these in here? So, which I'll show you. We'll go through the steps. Going to beat it up, grind it up, put it in a bag into smaller chunks. Then once you mix it up and lay it in there, it's going to be all chunky and stuff like that. But once you level your table out and sand it really good, it should give you a granite type effect, which if you've seen any granite countertops, you know that granite has all different crazy colors in it. Even though the base of the granite might be like a white, a black, blue, green, whatever it is, but the all the imperfections in it, all the different metals and the other different rocks that are in it is like all kinds of wild, crazy colors that usually don't have anything to do with the main piece itself. So that's what we're going to try to, or I'm going to try to do here. Mix all these up into my smoked resin. This should go. Give us some awesome, crazy colors in here. Hopefully it works. Should. Let's see why not. All right.